And welcome back to Live at 9. Right now, a campaign is underway to keep the city clean. It's called the 901 Keep It Clean campaign, and it features some big names from right here in the Mid-South.
Sebastian Carson, Mayor Jim Strickland, Pastor Gina Stewart, Penny Hardaway, just a few names who are getting involved. Executive Director Elder White and Board Chair Sid Lerner are with us this morning. So what is this campaign?
Oh gosh, it's a wonderful campaign that revolves around the spoken word.
Okay.
That allows these key people to encourage people to keep our city clean.
Like to pick up litter,
exactly.
Cut your grass, all that stuff.
Exactly.
And why the spoken word, so to speak?
Well, spoken word is becoming more popular amongst young people these days, so this is our way of capturing their attention.
Yeah.
Okay.
To see the mayor, you know, involved in the spoken word piece and all that. So,
is he going to perform spoken word? Because he was just here.
Yeah, we could have had him. We would have loved to have heard that.
Well, he's featured in the ad, so he's got his little bit in it.
Sid, you could talk him into it.
Oh, well, I've tried to talk him into things before. Only about 50-50.
We'll get that.
We have confidence in you.
Talk to us, though, about the demographics of those who are apparently littering these days. Who's doing it and why?
Oh, the offenders tend to be the age of 16 to 34. That's our target audience for you know, sending our messaging out to those folks. So,
what
that
age group, you think?
I just don't know. And it's typically women from what the state has researched. Yes.
Well, and maybe when you're young, you don't think about the long-term consequences, perhaps.
Well, that's, Mary Beth, that's the reason that we try to work with young people.
Yeah.
We have programs for the schools, cleanup programs, special events, recycle events, those kind of things.
But besides just it's more visually pleasing, why is it important to a community from a crime perspective, from just feeling good about yourself perspective to keep things clean?
The key word is livability. Having a clean city, having a place where people feel safe and feel good about their surroundings affects everybody's life every day. It makes them feel good about their city.
Maybe in ways we don't even realize.
That's right. And it's also one of the ways the city can best show its best side to the world. Is to show people this is a beautiful city, how clean it is, and how we care for each other and how we care for our environment.
Right.
Do you
and
think a lot of us have kind of slightly gotten away from that in recent years? Because, for so long, Memphis was known for, for being a very clean city, a beautiful city.
Yeah. Oh, yes. This is our 21st century version of trying to rally people around a clean city. Yes, we used to win awards, and it was all revolving around the Clean Up, Paint Up, Fix Up campaign.
Right.
So we think 901 Keep It Clean is a new version of that campaign that was held years ago.
And many of our citizens want to roll up their sleeves and help out. And for that reason, we have at Memphis City Beautiful a tool bank where people can, any community group can call, give us a call, and we will provide tools for them to borrow so that they can do a cleanup in their neighborhood.
Really?
Sid, tools. You are making it easy for a lot of us, aren't you?
Yeah, tools like what?
Shovels. Gloves, plastic bags for the refuse.
So you can kind of reserve them for a particular day.
That's right.
Is it one of those things, too, that when there is a little bit of litter, it grows? It's like people stop.
Yes, litter begins litter. If it's there, people more inclined to litter even more.
Yeah. So
that's why we encourage
these are very subtle but powerful signals that we pass to each other in the community.
Right.
What do you think, though, would be the challenge, though, of connecting, especially with some of these younger people, to say, this is not the thing to do? How much of a challenge will that be, though?
We've always found that the key to keeping the community clean is by having the children teach their parents about just how important it is to be in a clean environment.
Hey, that worked for the non-smoking campaign years ago, so it could work here.
So how can we all get involved in this?
Oh, they can just go to our website, MemphisCityBeautiful.org, and find out all about the campaign and
attend a spoken word event.
That's right.
Where you may or may not see Mayor Jim Strickland doing some spoken
words. That's right.
Exactly.
But you can find out about all the different programs and services we have that include things like the tool bank, but also we have a speakers bureau available so that if you want a speaker for your organization and want to find out more, we'll provide a speaker.
I love it. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much
for
what you're doing,
us.
For cleaning things up. Thank you.